today we are here to talk a little bit about the process of hand-rearing an owl. We have here two spectacle owls, really young, with approximately a month and a half. They are now completely eating by themselves. So the most difficult stage when you end rearing an owl is the first 2-3 days. In the first 2-3 days you really cannot give them any bone, any skin, any guts. It's really just muscle, and that's how it's really important to give a good supplement like the Carnipro from Wisbrook. We just give them from the first 3 days. After that we start to add some smashed bones, really really smashed, and some guts. After 12 days then they can be introduced to some fur or some feathers, and after 20 days they should be able to eat the whole prey, even if chopped. After one month they should be able to eat the full prey by themselves. The reason that we have to be really careful when we prepare the food, it's because the first 2-3 days they are not able to regurgitate, and then the first 10 days it's also really difficult for them, and the owls and the birds of prey, they have to take the feathers and the bones out, otherwise they cannot digest. If they are not able to do it, they will suffocate when they are trying to, and then they die. That's why normally we say that the first 5 days to 10 days it's really really difficult. After that it's almost impossible to see an owl sick or with some problem. These are two spectacle owls. We have also Ural owls, great owls, snow owls. The hand-rearing process is basically the same. Just some of them are bigger species, some of them are smaller species, meaning that some of them are able to eat full prey earlier than the other ones. This is a species from South America, but that adapt really, really well here to the weather of the Netherlands. So we are really successful in breeding them.